If you use Ancestry.com to research your Irish ancestors, you've probably encountered civil registration index records that list either 3-month or 1-year time spans for an event such as birth, marriage, or death. Believe it or not, that date doesn't show when your ancestor was born or died. In this video, I'm going to explain what these records mean and how to use them. I'm Mike O'Neill, and I'm a big data professional and amateur genealogist who has made tons of mistakes since I picked up genealogy as a hobby in 2011. I want to help you learn from my mistakes. Take a look at this Irish Civil Registration Births Index record for Sabina Gallagher. A quick glance might make you think Sabina was born in April, May, or June of 1884, but she was actually born on 4 March 1884. So what's happening here? The thing that I skipped over when I first encountered this particular source is the data label date of registration. Believe it or not, that date is when Sabina's birth was registered with the state, not when she was born. So why did it take so long for her birth to get registered? In 1864, England passed a law requiring that all births, marriages, and deaths be reported to a local registrar, typically the local poor law union, a geographic division within Ireland. If the event wasn't registered, you could actually be fined. Put yourself back into 1865. Let's say you're a poor Irish farmer subsisting off a teeny parcel of land in a rural townland when your wife gives birth to a new baby. Assuming you even know about the new law, which you probably don't because news was spread only through word of mouth, the Poor Law Union Register is 10 miles away by dirt road. Now, that's a day's journey round trip when the roads are dry, but maybe spring rains have turned that road into mud a foot deep. You're also busy planting crops for the next few weeks, so you put it off. Then maybe you get sick and put off the trip again. It might be months before you make the journey to register the birth of your child. Or maybe you're a midwife in 1880 who delivers a dozen or more babies a month, and you deliberately make the trip once a month rather than every time a baby was born. On top of that, you're a Roman Catholic, and you've been treated little better than a serf for hundreds of years, so you really don't want to cooperate with the English anyway. Maybe you delay reporting it for as long as you can without risking the fine.
No money.
You silly boy. Now back to you and me today. So what do you do with these indices? If you haven't watched my first video on Irish Catholic genealogy, well, you have to assume that there are multiple people with the same name. And if you're trying to match your ancestor's birth date recorded on a US document with an Irish document, the index just isn't going to cut it. You have to see that full document. Now, just a few years ago, getting the original document or a copy of the original document meant filling out a form and mailing it in to the General Register's office in County Roscommon. But today, if you're looking for records from the Republic of Ireland, it's all digitized at irishgenealogy.ie. Search for Sabina, look at civil registrations, and there she is. If you're looking in Northern Ireland, however, you still have to order the originals from the General Register's office in Northern Ireland. Thanks for watching my video. If you've got any questions, comments, or suggestions, please leave them in the comments.